formation of photochemical smog. For starting this chapter, we have to know, what is smog? Smog is a mixture of fog and smoke, which occurs in some busy industrial city. Smog is of two types. One is classical smog, and another is photochemical smog. Classical smog is produced by the combustion or burning of fossil fuels like coal, petrol or gasoline, etc., and caused by a mixture of smoke and sulfur dioxide present in air. Classical smog, also known as London smog, it's also reducing in nature. It occurs in cool, humid climate. Major constituents are smoke, fog and sulfur dioxide. It can occur both during the day and at night. In December 1952, London was trapped in a deadly cloud of fog and pollution for 5 days. At the time, the city ran on cheap coal for everything from generating power to heating homes, which was the result of classical smog. Photochemical smog is a type of smog produced when ultraviolet light from the sun reacts with nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds in the atmosphere. It is also referred to as summer smog or Los Angeles smog. It is an oxidizing smog and visible as a brown haze. It only happens in the presence of sunlight. Major constituents are hydrocarbons, ozone, PAN and nitrogen dioxides. It is most prominent during the morning and afternoon. Photochemical smog formation is influenced by the weather conditions, such as warm sunny days, gentle winds, lower level inversion, which is also known as thermal inversion, and combustion of hydrocarbon and nitrogen oxides. Sources of photochemical smog pollutants: volcanic eruption, forest fire, automobiles, industry, power plant, reaction of photochemical smog. At first, nitrogen and oxygen combine in the combustion process to form nitric oxide. Then, this nitric oxide oxidized in the atmosphere to produce nitrogen dioxide. Next, sunlight breaks down nitrogen dioxide into nitric oxide and an oxygen radical. The oxygen radical combines with molecular oxygen to form ozone. Ozone is the main component of photochemical smog. nitric oxide can remove ozone by reacting with it to form nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide can also react with the hydrocarbons instead of ozone to form other volatile compounds known as PAN, that means peroxyacetyl nitrate. Reactive hydrocarbon from auto exhaust interact with ozone too from a hydrocarbon free radical. This hydrocarbon-free radical rapidly reacts with oxygen 2 from another hydrocarbon-free radical. Then the free radical reacts with nitric oxide to produce nitrogen dioxide and the free radical hydrocarbon. This new free radical next interacts with oxygen to yield a stable aldehyde and hydroperoxyl radical. Hydroperoxyl radical, then reactive with another molecule of nitric oxide to give nitrogen dioxide and hydroxyl radical. The hydroperoxyl radical is extremely reactive and rapidly reacts with a stable hydrocarbon to yield water and regenerate the hydrocarbon-free radical, thereby completing cycle. The aldehyde may initiate another route by interaction with the hydroxyl radical, leading to the formation of an acetyl radical, peroxyacetyl radical, and finally peroxyacetyl nitrate. Peroxyacetyl nitrate is also known as peroxyacetyl nitrate. Effects of photochemical smog. Photochemical smog's effects cause eye irritation, damage to the respiratory system and vegetation. Photochemical smog was first identified in Los Angeles in 1944. In 2017, photochemical smog to envelop large parts of Beijing. Otherwise, in November 2017, the air pollution spiked far beyond acceptable levels in Delhi. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new video updates.